How to calculate your ideal body weight. If you are on a fat loss journey, often it can be hard to pick a body weight to shoot for. Don't worry, in this video, I'm gonna break down everything you need to know about how to choose your ideal body weight for you and your personal journey. I'm gonna talk about the body mass index, so the BMI calculator. Is that an effective way to determine a healthy ideal weight for you? And then I'm gonna talk about body fat percentage and how to choose your ideal body weight based on your goal body fat percentage, and if this is a better option when choosing your ideal body weight to shoot for in your fat loss journey. So as always, let's get right into it. But if you're new to my channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button and hit the bell so you get a notification when I release a new video, just like this one, every single week. My name's Michelle Roots, kinesiologist, personal trainer, nutrition coach, and motivation specialist with over 18 years experience in the industry, helping people increase lean muscle, decrease body fat to become the strongest, leanest, healthiest versions of themselves. And I created this channel because I want to help you as well. So you're on a weight loss or fat loss journey, or you're thinking about starting a weight loss or fat loss journey, and you want to pick a goal body weight to shoot for, but you really don't know where to start or what is a realistic body weight for you to shoot for based on where you're at today. So here's what a lot of people do when they're picking an ideal body weight. In their mind, they're picturing themselves and they're like, this is the weight I want to be at. And if this is you, no judgment at all. You are not alone. Trust me, I hear this on a daily basis. They are, say they're my age, 41 years old. And maybe when they were 22, they weighed 120 pounds. And they're like, I was skinny and I felt really good. And that's where I wanna get to. So say there's someone like myself, I'm currently 150 pounds, and they're trying to get to 120 pounds because that's how much they were when they were 22. Is this a realistic ideal body weight for a 41-year-old woman versus a 22-year-old woman? I don't know, but I'm gonna say most likely no. I don't like to crush people's dreams because of course anything is possible, but we also have to think of choosing our ideal body weight. We wanna think of our overall general health. What are we gonna do to get to that body weight? Is it gonna be healthy? Is it gonna be sustainable? Is it gonna be realistic? Another thing we have to think about, is your weight loss going to come from body fat or muscle mass? So if you do certain things to get to that 120 pound body weight, are you going to lose muscle mass on the journey? I think the first mistake people make is choosing a number that is much too low and not realistic or healthy for where they're currently at. Again, not crushing anyone's dreams. But what I always suggest is maybe we start with a different number and then see how you feel when you get to that number. And if you still want to keep going, you keep going. So if that's not the best strategy, again, if that's what you want to go for, by all means, no judgment here. I think there's a better way to approach this. Let's talk about the body mass index or the BMI. This is something that doctors use to determine if someone is a healthy individual and if they are at a healthy weight or how to determine an ideal body weight. And it takes into account someone's height, weight, and age to determine if they are at a healthy weight. So just to show you how this is calculated, I'm gonna pull up a calculator right here, a BMI calculator, which you can find on the internet and I will link in the description below. Here we are. So I am 41 years old. I am a female. I'm 5'8½", but we'll just put 5'8". That half matters a lot. I'm a basketball player, so I will take every half I can. And my weight is about 150 pounds. So then I calculate. So here we are. So I am in the normal range. So it says my BMI is 22.8. So here's the problem with the BMI. Now let's take a look at me. Okay, got some muscle definition, a little bit of ab action, okay, some muscles, some glutes. With a BMI rating of 22, so let's look at the ranges here. I'm gonna pull up a chart. So here's the BMI table for adults. So a normal adult would be 18.5 to 25. So that means I'm actually at, if you see this chart here, I'm actually at the end range. So I am getting close, you know, to the overweight. Yes, I'm still in the normal category, but I'm on the higher end of the normal. Now, if I was only using the BMI to determine if I was a healthy individual and I didn't know any better, I might look at that and be like, okay, I'm normal, but at the same time, why am I pretty close to the overweight category? Now, the problem with the BMI is it doesn't take into account muscle mass, bone density, and overall body composition. So someone who has more muscle on their frame, meaning they might weigh a little bit more, but their frame is still small, they might be classified as overweight using the body mass index, which, let's be honest, is not true. If you are someone who's lean and you have a six pack, but the BMI is telling you you're overweight, I don't think this is a good measure of determining an ideal body weight. If you are someone who's strength training and looking to build lean muscle and drop body fat versus just drop body weight. So if the BMI is not a great way to calculate our ideal body weight, what is something else we can do to help find a number to shoot for? Just want to take a minute to thank today's video sponsor, Element, one of my go-tos for replenishing my electrolytes after sweaty workouts. Electrolytes are so important for so many functions in the body, including hormonal regulation, nutrient absorption, and fluid balance. Sometimes water just isn't enough. And Element has the perfect balance of 1,000 milligrams of sodium, 200 milligrams of potassium, and 60 milligrams of magnesium. And better yet, zero sugar or artificial sweeteners, so no junk. Element can help prevent and eliminate headaches, muscle cramps, fatigue, sleeplessness, and other common symptoms of electrolyte deficiency. Right now, Element is offering my listeners a free sample pack with any order. That's 8 single serving packets free with any Element order. Get yours at drinkelement.com/Michelle. This deal is only available through my link. You must go to drinkelement.com/Michelle. There's another calculation that I'm going to show you, which takes into account your body fat percentage. Body fat percentage is the measure of the proportion of fat in your body relative to your total body weight. Why is your body fat percentage an important number to know? One, it's a health indicator. So one thing I'd like to point out is if you're going on a weight loss or a fat loss journey is it shouldn't always just be about vanity. It shouldn't always just be about, I want to look like so-and-so. I want to reach 120 pounds because my favorite celebrity weighs 120 pounds. You have to think first, no matter what age you are, and what I preach in every single video on my channel is I need to think health first. I am doing this to live a longer, healthier lifestyle. The stronger I am, the better I can function in life. So looking at body fat percentage as an overall indicator of health, excessive body fat is linked to so many health issues such as diabetes, heart disease, hypertension, especially if your body fat is located mainly in your midsection and what we call visceral fat. So that is the body fat you can't see. It's the body fat inside all around your organs. And that is the body fat that can be worrisome to your health. So this is why looking at weight loss versus fat loss, as well as muscle versus fat. But knowing your body fat percentage can help you come up with a better ideal body weight and body fat percentage to shoot for that is healthy and sustainable for you and your frame. There are many different ways to measure your body fat percentage, such as skin fold measurements, DEXA scans, what we call bioelectrical impedance. So those scales that you can stand on at the gym, sometimes you have them at home, you hold onto handles, or you just stand there and it sends an electric current through your body, hydrostatic weighing. But worst case scenario, if you don't have anyone to help you or you're not able to access any of these options to test your body fat percentage, I have a video already on my channel talking about how to test your body fat percentage at home right here. I'll link that video in the description below if you want to go check that out next to learn an approximate body fat percentage so you can start to do these calculations that I'm going to mention in a little bit in this video. So when looking at body fat percentages, I'll put this table up here. And this shows us just how to know what is a healthy body fat percentage for us. So you can see essential fat. So 2 to 5% for men, 10 to 13% for women. Athletes are typically 16 to 13% for men and 14 to 20% for women. Fitness, 14 to 17% for men and 21 to 24% for women. And acceptable, meaning not just acceptable, that means you're healthy, you're good. 18 to 24% for men and 25 to 31% for women. And then in the obesity range is 25% and higher for men and 32% and higher for women. So how can we use our body fat percentage and this chart to determine an ideal body weight? Now I'm going to show you a somewhat simple calculation you can do to determine your ideal body weight based on your lean body mass and body fat percentage. So I'm going to pull up this chart here. So step one is we're going to calculate our lean body mass. So lean body mass is the weight of everything in your body except fat. So that's your muscles, bones, and organs. Say I'm a woman who weighs 160 pounds and currently 30% body fat. Say I want to set the goal for myself to get to 25% body fat. My first step is to calculate my lean body mass. So to do that, I'm going to first determine my current body fat weight. So how much does the body fat weigh in my body? So I'm going to take my total body weight and multiply that by my body fat percentage. So my body fat weight is 160 pounds times 0.30, 30%, and that's 48 pounds. So from there, I'm gonna calculate my lean body mass. So to get that number, I'm gonna take my total body weight and I'm gonna subtract my body fat weight, so that 48 pounds. So my lean body mass is 160 pounds minus 48 pounds, so I have 112 pounds of lean body mass. So that's how much my muscles, bones, and organs weigh. So now that we have our lean body mass, we're going to try and find our ideal body weight based on that 25% body fat goal. So if we get to that 25% body fat, what body weight should we be goaling to see at that 25% body fat? Again, in a perfect world, meaning we're strength training, we're looking to either build or maintain muscle mass and drop body fat and not lose any of our muscle mass on our weight loss journey. Here's how we determine our ideal body weight based off that goal of 25% body fat. So if our target body fat percentage is 25%, we can find our target weight by using our current lean body mass divided by 1 minus 0.25. So 1 minus 25%. And we're gonna take that lean body mass number, so 1 minus 0.25 is 0.75. So I'm gonna take 112 pounds divided by 0.75 to give me 149.33 pounds. So if I'm currently sitting at 160 pounds at 30% body fat, with my goal of getting to 25% body fat, a realistic body weight for me to shoot for would be 149, 150 pounds. Now again, these are all just calculations, but a much better and more realistic way to determine a goal body weight based on your body fat percentage and your body composition versus just doing anything and everything you can to see the number go down on the scale. Now I know that was a lot of math. Depending on what day or time you are watching this, you might be like, okay, really? That's a lot. I'll leave it in the description or the video comments below so that you don't have to keep rewatching this part of the video and pausing and stuff to try and figure it out. Now, I just wanna close this video off by having a little bit more of a conversation about body weight. Now, I know I talk a lot on my Instagram and even in videos on this channel here, throw your scale out the window, who cares about that number? But being a female and just working with so many women all over the world, I understand that that number does mean a lot to people. And whether that's a good thing or a bad thing, there's really no getting around it. A lot of women care about that number. But here's the thing I want you to remember is how you get to that goal body weight is everything in determining if you're able to stay at that body weight. So if you are taking a journey where you're cutting out entire food groups or you're popping pills or you're in the gym for 5 hours a day and doing things that are not really sustainable or healthy or realistic, what is your plan to stay at that ideal body weight? How are you going to feel when you get to that body weight? Are you going to be upset if you go to the mall and no one comes up to you and says, "Whoa, you must weigh 120 pounds. Well done." Because here's the thing, no one's gonna say that. One thing that I like to really drill home is there nothing happens when you reach that number on the scale. But if you do it in a healthy, sustainable way where you're tracking your progress on a regular basis, you're eating to fuel your body, you're getting an understanding of calories, macronutrients, healthy foods versus unhealthy foods, healthy balance, learning that 80-20 rule that you don't have to starve yourself to get to a certain body type. And I will tell you one thing. So I'm 5'8½" and my body weight ranges between about 148 and about 152 or 153, you know, within that range up and down, depending on so many different factors. But I can tell you one, not one person, I can't tell you one time where someone has walked up to me in the mall, at the grocery store, even clients in my gym, my kids, like no one has ever walked up to me and said, "How much do you weigh?" But people have come up to me and said, "Wow, look at your arms. Wow, look at your shoulders. You look strong." There's so many different things that people come up to me and say, and I'm like, "Well, thank you very much." But they never once ask how much I weigh because it doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter. I think once you reach a stage where you stop just focusing all of your efforts and getting on that scale 5 times a day and praying to see a different number, when you start that mindset shift to measure your body fat percentage and track your progress in the gym, am I getting stronger? How are my clothes feeling? How are my energy levels? Am I sleeping better? How is my relationship with food? Is what I'm doing sustainable? Is this a lifestyle for me? Can I keep this up for the next 5 years? These are what all should be the determinant of your success. Because again, this whole weight loss, fat loss, this is all to live a long, healthy, happy life. It shouldn't all be for vanity. And there's nothing wrong if you do have goals of looking better and looking leaner. That's totally normal. And of course, everybody wants that. But there has to be something more to it to keep you motivated to stick to it, not just that number on the scale. So of course, the whole gist of this video was to help you come up with an ideal body weight. But I just want to send that message as well, in that body weight does not necessarily determine everything. So I think that's all I have to say for today's video. As always, guys, leave any questions in the comments below. I'm always happy to help. And if you need more help with your workouts or your nutrition, you can learn more about my one-on-one online fitness and nutrition coaching program, where you work with me one-on-one all through my online coaching app. I'll put a link to that program in the description below. And as always, have a great day, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.